Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, WrestleZone would like to welcome you to tonight's live event. Before we begin, please be advised that all WrestleZone stars are professionally trained, so please do not copy or imitate anything you see here tonight. Please also be aware that WrestleZone is proud to provide entertainment suitable for all ages, and we ask that you refrain from using any inappropriate language this evening.
Hello and welcome to the WrestleZone podcast. I'm your host, as always, Billy. Just here to give you a recap of this weekend's results from Granite City Showdown taking place at the Rich Energy Arena in Aberdeen. A nice new venue for WrestleZone, a nice full venue as well. It looks like it was a walk-up sellout. So it looked like it was bustling and just lots of bodies with room to expand as well as the big hall was kind of half tapered off. For the entranceway, so it looks like there could be even more space for future events if we see it as an Aberdeen Anarchy venue in the near future. I apologize in advance. I am full of the cold because that's just my January. It seems I just get ill, so I will make this as quick as possible, as recappy as possible, so you can find out what's happened this past weekend if you haven't went on WrestleZone social media already or got on to swnscotland.com and saw the full results. We'll have a write-up soon. I will also have, this Friday will be SWN podcast road trip edition, where you get to hear me ramble for over an hour about the show itself, going to the show and coming home from the event in the pitch black darkness. So I haven't recorded the back half of it yet, the bit in studio, but the bits I have done already, it's a fun little jaunt. Fun little thing that I've done there. So look forward to it. I certainly am. Look forward to getting it edited today. Anyway, Rich Energy Arena, January 20th, 2024 for Granite City Showdown. And the VIP ticket holder match saw William Sterling and Damien defeat the team of the Warriors against Low Life Entities, Rhys Dawkins and Brian Tucker. In a match that was highly entertaining. A lot of things happening in there. William Sterling got the tail end of a beatdown from Dawkins and Tucker. Eventually, I'll get their name right first go. Today's not that day. But Damien put in a lot of offense as well. They really had Dawkins and Tucker on the back foot quite often in this particular match, with a little bit of a maybe controversial circumstances when during a second rope maneuver, the most dangerous rope from Rhys Dawkins, William Sterling put his foot up, which ended up catching Rhys Dawkins right between, I can't think of an analogy right at this moment in time, it's Shakespearean, right between the legs. So that was clearly a victim of circumstance, I would say. I would like an official line from Dennis Law on that particular case as senior referee. I'm sure he's got an opinion to it, but like I say, I think it was a victim of circumstance, unfortunately, for Rhys Dawkins, that saw his giblets getting kicked, and getting the sweet shin music from William Sterling. But eventually, William Sterling and Damien used, I think it was the oil crash they used, the old Sterling Oil tag team maneuver. They used the oil crash, which saw them pick up the win, which was a great match, great way to kick off the VIP portion of the show. Kicking off the main show was Mickey Vago and Liu Kang Sharp. Sharp came in announcing very vehemently that he defeated Devon Dudley, which Mickey Vago took exception to because he was part of the team that defeated Devon Dudley. It was him. It was a rejected and Liu Kang Sharp taking on Thunder Buddies and Devon Dudley way back when. But the match itself, Liu Kang Sharp was very dominant throughout. Unfortunately, he got himself a little bit too cocky with singing "I Believe I Can Fly" and missing top rope maneuvers, the last of which saw him spin round into a stunner from Mickey Vago. Vago picking up the win. Tommy Rae didn't accompany Vago during the match, so it was just Vago on his own, picking up the win in a good, clean manner. We'll see how that helps him moving forward when it comes to Regal Rumble time, which is soon, March 30th. Carl Aberdeen tickets will be available today, as I think Monday. It should be available today. The worst tickets available at at the show as well, so you get your own physical ticket. I'm possibly going to try and pick mine up at Peterhead. We're going to go there on February 24th at the Palace Hotel. So hopefully going to pick up my ticket then. If not, because it's Regal Rumble, these tickets always sell fast. So I have to go and pick up my ticket a little bit earlier. But we'll soon find out and soon see. So yeah, quick turnaround for Mickey Vago after having looking sharp, really just hammer him throughout. He was Sharp's just one of those guys who if you give him an inch, he'll just sneak his way in and just maul at you. And Vago had to weather that storm in order to pick up the win with the stunner. Next up was a triple threat match. Oliver Green picked up the win over Zach Dynamite and Tommy Raiden. Big win for Oliver Green. Pinned Tommy following Zach Dynamite hitting a kill shot on Tommy Raiden, which ended up finding Zach Dynamite found himself being bundled out of the ring by Oliver Green, who then pinned Raiden, picking up the scraps and the victory. A shock win. Zach Dynamite was nonplussed to be there. He seemed very, very annoyed they had to deal with these young lads, as he constantly was slapping them, bullying them whenever he could, any opportunity arose. And the fact that he put in the finishing touches to the match by giving Tommy Raiden that kill shot, only to not get the pin, is just going to make him even more bitter, which he was later on in the show, which we'll get to. Oliver Green, he survived well. He got a Death Valley driver on the apron from Zach Dynamite as well, picking up another win there. In the win column. I think that's now three in a row for Oliver Green, and his first win on the main card as well of WrestleZone. So another big year on the cards for Oliver Green. Could this be his breakout in WrestleZone? We'll soon find out. In the first half main event, WrestleZone Tag Team Championships were on the line when the Outfit were defending their newly won titles from Christmas Chaos against the former champions, the Foundation of the Future, Ryan Riley and Bruiser Brad Evans. Back and forth all the way in this match. It seems that Outfit really have the inside track for the Foundation of the Future that no other tag team in Scotland certainly has right now. They were able to pick up the win. Again, another quite surprising win, picking up the pinfall over Ryan Riley, which really, that's really both members now pinned by the Foundation, by the Outfit, when it comes to tag team title matches. So looks like the Foundation really are at the back of the queue now for the tag team titles. Murphy got a big powerbomb from the duo. There was a Peep Peep special as well. We got Ted O'Keefe with his great snap spine buster, but it was all for naught for the Foundation of the Future when we saw the Outfit retain the titles and once again continue on as WrestleZone tag team champions. Following the match, Zach Dynamite headed out when the dejected Foundation of the Future stood in the ring, calling out the disrespect that they've been receiving recently in WrestleZone, calling out William Sterling, revealing to us that William Sterling is part of the management team of WrestleZone, goading Wonderful William into the ring for just a scrap and beating down William Sterling, much like they did to Mr. WrestleZone at Christmas Chaos. But before they could put the finishing touches on that knee of William Sterling with a chair, Damien arrived with a chair of his own to clear the ring. So this looks like it's far from over. So the Foundation of the Future are starting to maybe crack the foundations of WrestleZone as they're targeting established long time wrestlers in WrestleZone. We'll see how that develops as the months go on. It looks like we may see the road to Armed Anarchy begin right here at Granite City Showdown. Well, we'll soon find out. In a match that ended up taking a turn, the winner receiving Omar Mohammed's Shawani, even though Captain Allen ended up calling it a Shawani Wadi. Captain Allen Sterling, however, could not start off the year with a win, but Omar Mohammed was able to pin him falling double knees into the corner for a very comprehensive victory. But Captain Allen had his moments, of course, he always does, to frustrate and annoy the fans in attendance or his opponents in general with some just sheer buffoonery, but it wasn't enough with Omar Mohammed picking up the win with those double knees in the corner. A great start to the year for the sensational Omar Mohammed. And our penultimate match of the show, Evan Young returned. Mr. 2004 was the first time he's wrestled since Aberdeen Anarchy last year. He was able to pick up the win over Chris Archer, a frustrated Chris Archer, who, again, felt disrespected. There's a little bit of a through-line theme right now with some of the veterans and the long-time acts in WrestleZone, that they're starting to feel a little bit disrespected in general, either by fans or just everyone in general for their opportunities that they're not receiving or not getting. Chris Archer was apoplectic when he was pinned by Evan Young, and just not happy that Evan Young was able to gain that win using any excuse in the book that he could, pulling hair, doing cheating, even though Evan Young did neither of these things, and it was more Chris Archer who was taking the shortcuts as he could go on. But yeah, Evan Young picking up a win in his return, 2024, maybe 20 years old now. Mr. 2004 might make his year 2024. And before the main event, Flippy and Drippy themselves, Ronan King and Connor Malloy, they didn't let Skull Brawl enter the ring. So thanks to the divine intervention of Lost Boy Aspen and Mr. Patterson, it was agreed that this match would be a Tornado Rules tag team match, which meant that anything could happen, and it meant bodies were flying everywhere. And that certainly was the case, as we saw flips and drips and big throws and big chops and everything in between. These four guys absolutely went hell for leather against each other, which saw eventually Flippy and Drippy picking up the win. They pinned Caleb Valhalla following a powerbomb slash sliced bread combination, seeing Caleb being pinned. That doesn't happen often in WrestleZone. I think it's probably one of the first losses Lost Boy Aspen's got on his charter since winning the title at Christmas Chaos in 2022. So a big win, a big scalp already for Ronan King and Conor Malloy, as Flippy and Drippy look to take over WrestleZone and look to possibly gain some momentum when it comes to Regal Rumble time. Could we see these guys clash again in the near future, whether it's Peterhead, whether it's an Academy show, whether it's Regal Rumble itself, on the road to Aberdeen Anarchy? Like I said, I want to keep this one brief today just because, you know, lots of recording to do and my throat is killing me as it is, as it always seems to be after a WrestleZone show, because I'm shouting. Anyone who watches me at a wrestling show knows I don't do that. But a lot of talking points as well that I want to get into in other videos as well. But for the recap of the show itself, a great show from WrestleZone, a great way to start off 2024. I can't wait to get to, I'm hoping to get to Peterhead, but I can't wait, if not, for the Regal Rumble on March 30th. So get your tickets now. Go to ringsideworld.co.uk to get your tickets for Peterhead. Keep an eye on social media for the release date of Regal Rumble. And in the meantime, hope to see you at a show. This has been a very quick recap edition of the WrestleZone podcast. I've been Billy. Go to social media, find out more about WrestleZone at a show near you, and just go enjoy some wrestling. Have a good one.